a couple of years ago, we saw immense news from the United States government about the ban of Huawei. Huawei was recognized as a telecom and consumer electronics giant. They were winning contract after contract in various parts of the world. Their smartphone devices had also eaten up market share from famous brands such as Apple's iPhones and Samsung's wide variety of smartphones. As Huawei rose to fame, everything came to a halt in 2019. The company was severely impacted by US sanctions, as the company could no longer access critical technology and suppliers. These technologies and suppliers were crucial in maintaining the company's edge in the global markets. They could no longer work with companies like TSMC for advanced processors. Huawei could have gone down the drain and fell off, just like many other companies that get sanctioned. However, the company evolved. It eventually became not only China's famed telecom and consumer electronics giant, but also its semiconductor leader. Indeed, Huawei is now at the forefront of China's semiconductor landscape. It is worth noting that Huawei had previously been awarded numerous times for its blockbuster patent filings and its massive research and development spendings. Their entrance into the semiconductor industry could fuel the entire technology landscape of China. But before that, let's understand what are the strategies behind Huawei's semiconductor plans. Huawei's strategy in semiconductors centers on three main pillars: independent chip design, partnerships with domestic foundries, and investment in a resilient supply chain within China. The first essential piece in semiconductor manufacturing is design. But what is semiconductor design, you ask? Well, semiconductor design is the process of creating the architecture and blueprint for a chip's structure, specifying how it will function at a fundamental level. This involves determining the chip's layout, the arrangement of transistors, and how they interact to perform complex tasks. The design process is intricate, combining electrical engineering, material science, and software engineering to make chips powerful and efficient while keeping their size as compact as possible. At the core of Huawei's semiconductor plans is its in-house design. Huawei's HiSilicon division, long responsible for designing the company's Kirin smartphone chips, has redirected its resources toward developing chips for Huawei's own use in telecommunications, cloud computing, and artificial intelligence applications. With HiSilicon, Huawei has established a significant edge by creating application-specific integrated circuits and AI chips, which serve as the foundation for various Huawei products in fields less impacted by sanctions, such as networking and cloud services. Just take a look at the smartphones that the HiSilicon Kirin processors power. Before the sanctions hit, Huawei's Kirin-powered smartphones were competitive in nearly every aspect, and in some cases, even ahead of flagship models from other brands. Huawei's Kirin processors, particularly the Kirin 9000 series, were designed with cutting-edge performance in mind, rivaling Apple's A-series chips and Samsung's Exynos processors in terms of speed, AI capabilities, and energy efficiency. These were seen in Huawei's flagship devices, such as the Mate 40 Pro. Some benchmark tests showed that the Kirin 9000 achieved scores comparable to Qualcomm's Snapdragon 865 Plus and Apple's A14 Bionic, making it one of the most powerful chips in the Android ecosystem at the time. And indeed, Huawei designed this chip by themselves. But this Kirin 9000 series was manufactured by TSMC's 5-nanometer process. TSMC is no longer supplying chips to Huawei due to the sanctions. So, what are the chips that Huawei now uses for their latest smartphones? Well, one of the recently launched chips was the Kirin 9000S series. Reports show that they are now manufactured domestically in collaboration with Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation, China's largest semiconductor foundry. Although SMIC's capabilities lag slightly behind TSMC's in terms of process nodes, they've made significant strides, enabling the production of these new Kirin chips on a 7-nanometer process. This is, however, lower than TSMC's more advanced 4-nanometer or 3-nanometer chips that they produce for the smartphone industry. This Kirin 9000S is found in Huawei Mate 60 Pro, and according to various online-based benchmarks, they haven't really performed well compared to the smartphone industry average. Well, the answer is obvious, considering its use of 7 nanometers rather than 4 nanometers or 3 nanometers chips. Now, beyond the design of chips, it is also necessary to manufacture these chips. Chip manufacturing is far, far more important than the design of chips. That's because chip manufacturing, also known as semiconductor fabrication, is where the blueprint or design of a chip comes to life. Manufacturing involves creating actual silicon wafers that contain millions or even billions of microscopic transistors, all meticulously arranged according to the design blueprint. Each step in this process requires extreme precision and advanced equipment, as even the smallest error could lead to malfunctioning chips. In advanced chip manufacturing, the process node, measured in nanometers, NM, is critical. This number represents the size of the transistors on the chip. The smaller the node, the more transistors can fit onto a chip, making it more powerful and energy efficient. Industry leaders like TSMC and Samsung have advanced to manufacturing nodes as small as 3 nanometers, which are currently the top of the line for performance and efficiency. However, because of sanctions, Huawei can only access the 7 nanometer that we mentioned. And the only corporation who can do this in China is Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation. The partnership between the two is critical. One is a leading foundry service provider in the country, and the other a leader in consumer electronics and is actively investing in chip designs. Thus, a big part of Huawei's chip plans is cultivating this partnership. How can they both move from a 7-nanometer to a 5-nanometer chip is going to be the challenge for them. Now, the weird part about Huawei's use of 5-nanometer chip is that their laptop, which was launched in early of 2024, was using a TSMC-made 5-nanometer chip. Huawei's high-silicon Kirin 9006C was found and being used in their Qingyun L540 laptop. Initially, there were rumors that a Chinese company did it, but it was actually TSMC. For Huawei and Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation, the 5-nanometer is still far off. But again, there are a lot of rumors that were published early this year. In March of 2024, Huawei and presumably the Chinese Foundry Corporation have submitted patents for their new chip production, called self-aligned quadruple patterning, with the goal of producing 5-nanometer chips. Then, on top of the 5-nanometer chip, Huawei and partners have been reported to go further than their 5-nanometer chip. They are now eyeing quadruple patterning techniques for 3-nanometer class manufacturing technology. Finally, the most important piece of Huawei's semiconductor strategy is its creation of a robust, largely self-sufficient supply chain within China. Huawei, over the years, has quietly established itself as a dominant force in the domestic semiconductor ecosystem, sourcing raw materials, components, and assembly services from within the country. This supply chain independence allows Huawei to withstand external pressures more effectively than its competitors. By building strong ties with Chinese semiconductor firms across the value chain, Huawei is making strides toward a vertically integrated supply chain, capable of supporting the development and mass production of advanced chips. This domestic ecosystem is part of Huawei's longer-term vision to shield itself, and by extension, the Chinese tech sector, from geopolitical disruptions. Now, the question is, will Huawei deliver? Of course, it's difficult to say whether they can or not, but what stands true is Huawei's continuous dedication to research and development spending. In 2022, it allocated over 161.5 billion Chinese yuan, or 25.1% of its revenue, to research and development, marking one of the highest R&D budgets among global tech companies. This commitment is primarily aimed at developing proprietary technologies that would enable Huawei to circumvent international supply limitations. Just take a look at their latest in-house chips. Huawei's Ascend AI series are already making waves in the field of artificial intelligence. These chips support Huawei's ambitions in AI, cloud computing, and smart devices, fields that are less impacted by sanctions compared to consumer electronics. Then, there are also Huawei's Kunpeng processors, which serve as a critical component of its cloud computing and server hardware offerings. Based on ARM architecture, Kunpeng chips enable Huawei to provide computing solutions that are competitive domestically and in certain international markets. These processors are widely used in Huawei Cloud, one of the fastest-growing cloud service providers in China, and play a key role in Huawei's commitment to providing everything from infrastructure as a service to expertise as a service. Now, the future of Huawei's chip plans are still unknown. But from the looks of it, they may eventually help China emerge as a global player. But anyway, do let us know what you think. Thanks for watching.